Happy show day.
It is obviously Saturday, the 14th of September, and we're here without some hiccups, but that's okay. Maybe we'll talk about that later, Libby.
Yeah, maybe.
We're here. It's almost 5:30 in the AM. We're just starting on our fluids for the morning. We've got our meals packed. About to make a coffee, hopefully get things moving. Woke up at 87.3 this morning. And we're looking tanned.
Looking nice.
So the tan has sat and soaked in quite nicely. But yeah, honestly, the plan of attack right now is to just chill out, have a coffee, not to stress out too much, pack up all the bits, maybe do some photos at about 6:30 when it gets light, and then
get moving
about 7-ish, maybe before 7. So we should be in good timing, but we got videographer Liv on the camera today.
Yeah.
They said all good for the camera to be backstage. So that's all good, just can't use that filming
on stage.
So you probably just end up filming a bit on
there'll just phone. Be some phone clips, yeah.
Yeah, which is fine. So yeah, we'll take you through the day.
Ooh.
So I've just done a little bit of posing, but unfortunately it's raining outside. Even though it's light, I don't want to risk it outside with the tan, that's for sure. So I just popped the trunks on. Did it in a spare room under some, I say average lighting,
yeah.
Not normal lighting, but it is what it is. I think we're happy. Onto the second brew. Hopefully promote some diuresis. Maybe half a bottle down, give or take. Try now this in the next sort of half an hour-ish. I've also got my first meal as well, which we'll have in the car. We're about to leave shortly anyway, so get everything sorted. Bags packed. All the things. We've got pillows, we've got towels, we've got hoodies, pump-up bands, pump-up products.
Scales.
All the bits and bobs, but anyway, we'll be on the road shortly. So we just pulled up next to you. That's okay. Righto. It's like deja vu. We're literally in the same car park as last night, or car space. So it's literally, a lot of literally things right now. It's 7:30 a.m. On point. Getting meal number one in.
Some
cold chicken and rice.
Dark chocky.
It's 100 grams raw weight rice. 50 grams of chicken, so not much. 20 grams of 95% dark chocky, not melted, by the way. So that was obviously in the last vlog. I also posted that on Instagram with a poll, and renowned, like everyone,
overwhelmingly
it was a yes. So only 3 people I think said no, and in double figures amount of people said yes. So definitely think dark chocolate melted. Unfortunately this is not melted because it's cold. And there's also 3 grams of salt on here as well, as per standard. I've also nailed 1.5 of water because I've been up for 2 hours and had a couple coffees at the same time, and we still haven't gone to the bathroom, but I suspect there's not much to come out given that it's TMI, but I went good one after probably meal two or three or four yesterday.
And it's just been...
Yeah, I've had like 2 meals since then.
Yeah.
And I think I'm still pretty tight. So,
I'm ready.
And then, it's also raining as well.
Yeah, can't really tell.
Like I said, in my check-in, yeah, that's why I couldn't do check-in photos earlier. Oh. Because it's raining, so... We'll see how we go.
We've got the umbrella and we shall figure it out.
Anyway, until then.
Catch me in there.
Catch ya.
Right lap. Do it again. Drop for a sec. Do it again. Just hold it tight. Better. That one's good. All right, hold. Can you smile? Quarter ten. Front double. And relax, front lat spread. Good. Okay, relax side chest. That's tight. Abs. Good, squeeze. And relax side chest. Turn the elbow. Yes. We're spiking. Yeah. Squeeze abs to the turn the hips to the left. Yes. And relax facing the rear of the stage.
Have I got any bodybuilders in here?
Yes.
All right, guys, we're going to start to get you moving downstairs shortly.
Okay, rear double.
I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm still learning about life. My woman brought children for me so I can sing them songs and I can tell stories. Still my boys are with me. Some are still out seeking glory and some I had to leave behind. My brother, I'm still savvy. Soon I'll be 60 years old. My daddy got 61. Remember life and then your life becomes a better one. I made a man so happy when I rode a little once.
The overall bodybuilding, which is pretty cool. So I might shower, rinse off, and then might give you a bit of a rundown. I'm not sure what footage might be before this. Olivia's filmed a fair bit backstage.
Yeah, probably a bit of a little bits and pieces.
Some camera footage and all of that, but we took home the overall in bodybuilding, which is pretty freaking cool. So got the trophy, bodybuilding overall. This as well, a couple firsts, because I did do the open as well as the under 40 category.
Yeah.
So won both of those. Then in the overall, took the cake. So I think it's time for a shower. It's also quite cold, and I've got to rinse his tan off, and it's only not even 2 o'clock. But anyway, anything else to add, Olivia?
Nah.
Successful day, job
successful
done.
Successful day.
Tick job done. Box. Show number one, that's a wrap. But yeah, I might.
Recap after.
I need a shower and then we'll jump on the couch and the post-show treat. The Peppy Max vanilla in a 600ml bottle. Now that was the condition. Not just a can and not out of a glass.
Hasn't had any sugar-free beverages all week. Not particularly intentional, but...
Yeah. Actually, I probably had one on Wednesday, mate.
Oh, okay.
No, maybe Tuesday.
Anyway, it's been a minute.
Been a few days. Yeah. And we've got a sun kiss as well. They're my treats this afternoon. Anyway, let's shower. You ready for this?
Yeah. But how can you eat your own? Yeah. Delicious.
Most satisfying part. Round it off. Okay, let's recap. So, as I eat my chicken and egg whites with my 3 grams of salt and my Peppy Max vanilla. So a bit of a recap. We I'm actually quite hungry. We got to the venue at 7:30-ish and then went and saw the tanners pretty quickly. Got my top coat done. No, I got a base coat done.
No, it's a top coat.
A top coat. and then it was about 8:30. I think we had our 8:30-ish. We had the athlete.
Yeah,
the athlete. What do you call it? Briefing for the first show. And then the show started at 9:00. And bodybuilding was first up. So I was pretty quickly.
I think there were 2 categories before you.
Yeah, and then pretty much straight after the athlete. Briefing, I went and got glossed, glazed, sprayed, whatever you want to call it. That's where you just don't put your clothes back on after it. And that's just with canola oil. But that was good. Got all glazy and that's what you need under the lights. And then, yeah, pretty quickly, as I said, we're into the bodybuilding. Had a few categories like first timers, juniors, intermediate, yada, yada, yada. There's a few people in that. And then started pumping up and it was probably about 9:30. I reckon I was on stage for the under 40s.
Yeah, which was also combined with the under 25s, as there was only one of them.
You need to get in the shot, Libby.
Yeah, sorry.
And then, so I took that one out, the under 40s. So there's only 3 of them. So I took that out and literally straight after I came off, went back on for the open and there was actually 8 of us. So they split us up into 4.
Two fours.
Yeah, 2 fours while we're on stage.
and did the symmetry poses. And then they lined us all up and did the muscularity round, of which I was in the middle for, I say in the middle, but there's eight of you, so two people are in the middle. And then they actually moved, so the two people either side of me, I was pretty confident they were second and third. So then they moved me, because then they wanted to compare those two. So they moved me outside of the middle, and then those two then were able to be next to each other, which I was pretty confident.
I panicked.
Libby might have panicked, but I was pretty confident that meant that I was first and they were comparing second and third. So then...
they were up there, might I add, they're two... this was... they did three rounds by this point. They then did a third round there, because you did your round in your four, and then you all came together and you did a round, and then they moved these two people and they made them do another full round. So three rounds deep, and like they made them hold the poses for a solid 20-30 seconds.
Stu, head judge who was calling it, like he'd call the pose and then he was going and talking to one of the other judges, obviously to, you know, reconvene.
To confer, but like you can see that he's not immediately about to say and change. So definitely tested the endurance of all the other guys up there.
But with that being said, it's obviously hard because you know how you're feeling. You don't necessarily know how you look under the lights, on stage, all of that. And equally, you don't know how everyone else is looking. You can see people backstage pumping up, but, you know, that's a different story when it comes to on stage. Anyway, and then so I won the Open, which got me that big trophy.
Got you another medal.
Oh, got me another medal. That's right.
And then, of course, you'd already won the under 40, so you're already in the overall.
Yeah.
But then you took out the Open, so no one else from the Open was particularly correct in the overall.
So then it just
unless
doesn't...
already won.
It just doesn't make sense the way they do it, that they have then the overall, the overall, which is winners from all other categories. But you'd think if you win the Open, which is then what happened anyway. So then they took us through that. I feel like they didn't make us hold those poses as long in the overall because...
yeah, you only did a round, yeah.
It was only people that I was competing
against.
And
what were you, five or six?
Yeah, it might have been five or six.
Yeah.
In that one. So, yeah, took out that. That's where I got the trophy. That's where Libby got to come on stage.
Yay.
Which was fun. Obviously, AJ's
coach
in the UK, so he wasn't able to attend. But anyway, did that. And then that was done by like 10:30. And that was all back to back to back.
Yeah.
So I'd done however many rounds of posing.
I think in between Open and overall, I ran upstairs because I was like, there's a lot of posing, like, let's get some salt.
Yes.
Not that, you know, look, he was probably the least, it wasn't cramping, it wasn't resetting, but I was like, probably required if you're about to do another two, three rounds, who knows. So down some salt and a bit of water quickly, but.
Yeah, I had little doggy bags of salt, so I'd just chuck them to the dome, have some water. And by that point, I was about 2.5 liters of water deep. Which is perfect, and that's where it needed to be. Sodium was good in the pump-up formula, all of that. So I had all of that down pat. And then post that, it was like 10:30. Went outside, hung out with everyone. Obviously my family, her family, friends, all of that, which is terrific for everyone to come. So we need to make sure everyone sends us those pics that remember that we took.
There'll be lots. Yeah. Oh, yes.
So I can do a post about it, maybe.
Yeah.
And then... yeah, and the posing routine was about an hour and a half later, a bit after 12-ish. So I think there was... ended up only being six posing routines. So if I get a good video of the posing routine, maybe I'll pop it in at this point, now in the video.
I'm still learning about life. My woman brought children for me. So I can sing the
and hopefully there's a posing routine just before this. So, yes, 7 years, Lucas Graham, because Sean Clarida, 2022 Olympia. I said it to Olivia when we were at the Olympia 2022, so almost 2 years ago. I want to post this song.
Great song. You were like, yeah, this is awesome.
So, I was very happy with that. And then, yeah, the posing routine, I don't know what quite they mark it on, but the guy who won the classic overall.
And who had come second to you in bodybuilding.
Yep. He won the posing. He was a great poser. No question about that, which is good. So he then came second then in the posing, which obviously makes sense given that I'm not the best poser. But anyway, and then we just hung out. Took some pics with some people, chatted a bit, and it's like 2:30 now, which is pretty cool. I had a bit of time in between the, like the overall and the routine, whereby I was able to
have a meal.
Yeah, have a meal in between, and then look through. Olivia had some photos, so I was able to have a look because, as I said before, you kind of then don't know what you look like, and how you look on stage. So
obviously, they think you look the best compared to everyone else, but yes, it's still, you don't know what you look like yet.
And then as AJ said yesterday, it's kind of like today was kind of a 90% look. You know, there's definitely improvements to be made. You know, it can be sharper through the hams from the side and from the back. The glutes can be obviously sharper. Posing can be better. So yeah, that's work to be done. And given where we were at last night, yeah, happy to make it to stage.
Precisely.
So yeah, we've that's the first one. We're 8 days out from A&B, which it's actually funny because they interviewed me, one of the guys. Oh, actually, that's the other thing to talk about. I had to do a drug test. I had to do a piss test.
Yeah, of course.
Pissed in a bottle.
Cup. Two cups, in fact.
Two cups, yep. It was quite yellow, but not that I was too dehydrated, but managed to get some out, which is good. Signed that off, so I might be able to say that I'm actually fully natty, which I know I obviously am, but it's going to be cool to get the outcome of that. And yeah, they interviewed me and they're like, oh, what's on for post show? And as you can see, I've got chicken and egg whites sitting here in front of me and a Pepsi Max. So it's all fun and games. We've got legs on the cards tomorrow and then we're 8 days out from A&B. So we're entering another peak week, which is pretty cool. But yeah, that's all to report, I think. Obviously got a lot of messages to look through. A lot of photos to look through as well. Might have put up a post at some point, which will be pretty cool. So I think I might round out the vlog here.
Show day number one.
Sorry about that. Anyway.
She was.
That's show day number one done. If you like, I don't know what this is going to look like. This is a 10-minute clip almost of us chatting shit. There was a few from this morning and all of that. There'll obviously be some show day footage. I'm going to see what that looks like. But obviously, there's been plenty on the gram anyway. So with that being said, appreciate all those that have followed and supported. There was plenty there. Plenty of people coming up and saying that they followed me on Instagram and all of that and seen all of the content. So appreciate all of you guys. But until next time, we'll catch ya. Olivia, you want to add anything? She's mid bite. Come on.
No, hot talk.
Backstage coach.
Mm-hmm. Crush it.
Catch you in the next one. All right. So I know I've already outroed the video, but I figured I wanted to just elaborate a bit more. So I've got to be a little bit quiet because Olivia's just sleeping on the couch. Anyway, as I'm editing up this video, I feel like I want to convey a bit more. So, obviously, I just firstly want to say thank you to everyone who came to the show. I've obviously sent them relevant messages and whatnot, thanking them. You know, bodybuilding can be quite a isolating sport in terms of being such an individual pursuit, but there's so many people that come behind it. Obviously, there's Olivia who supports this greatly, so her support is incredible, unwavering, obviously not only today, the day of the show, but throughout, it's been 32 weeks, this prep so far. So yeah, I can't thank her enough. And you know, the amount of support now that I go through all my Instagram messages, people like, you know, followed you since 2020, followed you since the lockdown days, followed you since your first show, that kind of thing. And even at the show today, the amount of people that come up to me and say, hey, follow on Instagram, you know, like, it's actually slightly overwhelming, the amount of people. And you know, it's something that you think about, all these people, and you're just like, it's very, very, almost lost for words as to, you know, what this means, you know, to go through all this over the journey and finally bring something to stage. So, you know, to have that translate, have people come, enjoy it with the people that you care about. It's an overwhelming amount of support, which I couldn't be thankful enough for. So, yeah, it's a good start to the season. Obviously, we know that the job's not done, just the start, but yeah. Maybe this is the end of the vlog. So with that being said, thank you. Good afternoon, good evening, whenever you're watching.